everybody. Mitchell Mr. Hockey here. And if you thought the Max Pacioretty trade shook up the league enough, you're wrong. The San Jose Sharks just announced that they have just acquired defenseman Erik Karlsson, a two-time Norris Trophy winner from the San Jose Sharks, for 4 players and 2 draft picks. Now, there was a lot of emotion as the Senators were sad to say goodbye to Karlsson, and the Sharks are welcoming him with open arms. So it's very different, the feelings. One says goodbye, one says hello. There have been rumors about Erik Karlsson getting traded for a long time, but the timing of the trade surprised me. Remember when the Senators acquired Dion Phaneuf a couple years ago? That was supposed to be the start of their turnaround and become one of the Eastern Conference elite teams, but they're stuck at the bottom of the table. Last year, they missed the playoffs by 30 points. At the time of the Phaneuf trade, they had Craig Anderson in net, Erik Karlsson, Mark Muthot, Cody Ceci, and Phaneuf on the back end. They had the forwards in Bobby Ryan, Mark Stone, Kyle Turris, Mika Zibanejad, Jean-Gabriel Pajot, and Mike Hoffman. Remaining players, Anderson, Ceci, Stone, Pajot, and Ryan. They did get Matt Duchene, but they did have to pay a hefty price. They keep going with the same strategy. Acquire a guy, trade a guy. Acquire a guy, trade a guy, and so on. As a result, Guy Boucher, the head coach, he has no main guys for which he can work with. Okay, so now you're all wondering, why am I giving you all this trade, players, all that stuff? The reason I'm giving you this is because I'm trying to explain to you that it signals an end in my mind of a chapter in Senators history. I think until they can make another deep playoff run, I think Bobby Ryan, Pajot, they won't be the players they are right now. They got in this trade are Michael Bodker, Chris Tierney, Chris DeMille, Balzers, and the rights to undrafted forward Joshua. They also got a 2019 second round pick and a 2019 or 2020 first round. The Sharks also acquired Francis. What I think this trade means for Ottawa is that they're not going to be a contender for a couple years. Yes, they drafted Brady Tkachuk, but he's not going to turn things around overnight. For the Sharks, though, this trade is golden in my eyes. Yes, they had to part ways with Bodker, Tierney, and DeMello, but look who you just got. Now you have arguably the top 2 offensive defensemen in the NHL. I'm so excited to see how well Burns and Karlsson will play together. For the Sharks, you'll have your 2016 Western Conference champions, minus Tierney, Bodker, and DeMello, and also Patrick Marleau, who signed with the Leafs last offseason, but plus Erik Karlsson and plus Evander Kane. I think that's a pretty good team. I think they're destined for the third round at least. Back to the Senators. So now your core is an aging Craig Anderson in goal, Dion Phaneuf, Cody Ceci, Chris DeMello on the back ends, forwards Michael Bodker, Chris Tierney, Bobby Ryan, Mark Stone, Matt Duchene, Brady Tkachuk, and Jean-Gabriel Pajot. All those players, I feel they need to build around Brady Tkachuk because he's really young, he's really talented, he's a complete player in my mind. I just don't feel you could build around Matt Duchene because he's more of a smaller guy. He doesn't have the full set of skills the way I think Brady Tkachuk sends owner Edwin Melnick in a letter to the fans, said that his team will be rebuilding for about a couple years. Sharks now, this is the time to win. Next 3 years, I think. Because after that, some players will be aging. But I think right now, you may be able to steal a championship because you have the top 2 offensive defensemen in the league, I think. And they can cover if other players don't produce as much. I still think they will need Thornton and other forwards to win a championship, but I think with their back end of Brent Burns and Erik Karlsson, I think they can win a championship. So I feel for the Sharks, it's a big steal. Senators, good luck to you this season. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.